So you've heard open cell spray foam is recommended for a residential project, but are there any issues or concerns with it? Yes, there are a few. Let's talk about it. So with any building material, especially insulating material, there are some shortcomings and things to keep in mind. When you're looking at open cell spray foam, for example, one possible concern is overspray. Keeping in mind that, yes, of course, it is a sprayed on application, so for lack of a better term, there is a certain amount of splatter when you're spraying onto a surface, but also open cell expands a lot, meaning if there is a gap or a crevice or anything like that on a wall assembly or going from one room to another, that open cell will find its way into all those cracks and crevices and will expand itself through. There's also a chance that some of it can be sprayed through those gaps. So this is something that the install team really needs to be conscious of and has to look over the project beforehand to really be sure of what's on the other side of these walls. Are there any gaps or things like that? Because yes, that open cell is going to want to expand and fill all of those. So just one thing that a crew will have to keep in mind when installing open cell spray foam. Another thing to keep in mind, and this is more on the homeowner side of things, is that open cell can be very fragile. If you have exposed open cell, you can go right up to it, grab a piece and tear it out, no problem. Now this can be good because if you have to cut into it for something, it's easy to work with. However, if you have a wall in a garage or a pole barn, for example, that might be exposed, if you bump into that or put something against it, it will likely damage that foam. Same thing can be said for an attic that you might use for storage. If you push something into that foam, you're likely going to tear a piece off. So this is something to keep in mind that you do have to be a little more conscious of where that foam is if you're going to be working around it because you don't want to damage it. Now, the last point I want to make about open cell spray foam and something just to be aware of is potential for water infiltration. Now, no, I'm not talking about the myths that you see usually on the internet about open cell absorbing all this water. Now, to be clear, there are some open cells on the market that do absorb water. However, any premium spray foam that you're using, any reputable contractor should be using an open cell that does not wick or absorb water. Just keep that in mind. What I'm talking about though is a very specific couple situations. One thing that comes to mind is if you have a crawl space or a basement that's prone to flooding. Let's say you have a house that's near a lake, okay, and that crawl space floods a couple times a year. Well, if you know that you have a pre-existing water issue, I would not recommend open cell usually. You may wanna go with something like a closed cell, maybe insulate a different area of the crawl space, maybe move to more encapsulating versus insulating. So it's something to keep in mind when it comes to open cell and a known water exposure. They don't usually go well together, so you want to consider some other options. So if you want to learn more about if open cell is a good option for your house or what your house should have in general, click the link below, go to our learning center where we have all kinds of videos, articles, and guides, everything you need to know to make your home more comfortable and energy efficient. This is the Professor of Foam reminding you that building is a science.